All right, so we got something a little new here today. We have a Grundig radio, multi-band radio, and something new for me. We're going to plug it up. I was told it was working, so we're going to plug it up and see. Before I brush any dust or dirt out of here, I've raked a little out with my finger, and as you can see, it's like caked. So we're not going to let it run long. It has one fuse right here, and if it's working, that fuse is good. I'm going to plug it up. We're going to run through the channels. They did bring me an original, which I thought was pretty cool, antenna. It's an external antenna. I believe it's to pin up on the wall behind the radio. And it has an awesome internal antenna. And for some reason, somebody cut the cord and patched onto it. I don't know why they would do that, because there's a pretty awesome internal antenna up in here. And even if you can see this little lever right here, this is a directional antenna, and I'm going to be very careful with it, because it seems like it's working perfectly, and it's a directional antenna. You can see the cog here that turns when you turn the little dial on the front, and it makes this a directional antenna. And I think that's pretty cool. I don't think I've ever seen a radio set up like this. It's very high quality. Here's some big capacitors. From the looks of it, there's two in this can. And we may be able, if I can get some glasses, give me a minute, we'll see if we can get a date code off this big capacitor. But I can tell you right now, with that quality, in the year that this was made, I'm going to suspect that there's going to be very high quality capacitors in this radio. And other than maybe some electrolytics that we find, like in the first power stages, we're probably going to leave the bypass caps alone. If what I see here is an indication of any of the quality of the radio. Now, it is, of course, a tube radio, or I wouldn't even be working on it. And y'all, it uses, I don't know if you can see, but EL84 power tube. That's a tube used in a lot of guitar amplifiers. So I'm gonna plug this in. I'm gonna pause as I'm gonna plug this in. I'm gonna get some glasses. And we're going to dial on it a little bit and see if I can get some stations now. This is an all-metal building, so it's tough to pick up radio stations. But I think if I use the supplied external antenna and just run through some channels, I should at least be able to get some strong ones, pick up some strong ones in here. And our main object here is to not tear anything up, because it's working now. I want to get out some of the caps that may be extremely leaky, that might cause damage to components downline. But I was told it sounds really good, so we're going to crank it up and see. The bass response out of this thing is pretty amazing. I don't want to get a copyright strike, so we're going to keep on turning. I noticed the dial's backwards. A little dirtiness in the rheostats. From what I can tell, this is bass, and this is treble. It says so right here, bass and treble. Gonna see if we can.
Automated decor, pre-lit wreaths, garlands, and trees, LED string lights. We can park by the door and get in and out fast. Ace of Jackson. Good people doing it right. North Island at Volunteer Boulevard.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware.
At McCoy's Heating and Air, our number one priority is keeping...
We'll get that dirt out of those rheostats as soon as we get her apart and get her... get all those spots cleaned up. Y'all, this radio is in excellent condition. Now, of course, this isn't going to work because I have the internal antenna unplugged and the external antenna plugged in. But this is the directional antenna that's inside this thing. It's got some kind of a window here. It's supposed to tell you... radio strength. AM channels would do way better at night. And in this metal building, I'm not sure. This is actually weighted, which is pretty cool. Turn it down a little bit.
Thursday, December 15th, all donors get a Holiday Hero t-shirt and a certificate for a 10-inch Marco's Pizza at Lifeline Blood Center on Sterling Farms Drive in Jackson.
92.3 The Hog, West Tennessee's classic rock.
Whoa, there's some treble.
My home angel, looking for my seat. She was pure like snowflakes, no one could ever stain.
Look at the grill claw.
The glory of my angel could never cause the pain.
This thing's rocking, man.
And there's my home angel on the pages in between. My blood runs cold.
All right, enough. No copyright strikes here. All right, y'all. I'm going to unplug it. I'm going to... let it sit so we can bleed some voltage off those capacitors that's stored. And we're going to take the chassis out and see what we got going on, okay? This is actually weighted, which is pretty cool. Turn it down a little bit.
Thursday, December 15th, all donors get a Holiday Hero t-shirt and a certificate for a 10-inch Marco's Pizza at Lifeline Blood Center on Sterling Farms Drive in Jackson.
92.3 The Hog, West Tennessee's classic rock.
Whoa, there's some treble. This thing's rocking, man. Wow. All right, enough. No copyright strikes here. All right, y'all. I'm going to unplug it. I'm going to let it sit so we can bleed some voltage off those capacitors that's stored. And we're going to take the chassis out and see what we got going on, okay? Trying to tell if that tube is cracked. No, no, it's not cracked. That's the plate, I see. It's not going to air. The good news is, looking at the tube pattern on the back over there, these tubes are common to a lot of guitar amplifiers. So if one is were to go bad, I think you can still get them all fairly easy. Going to check this electrolytic right here, this one, maybe this one here, but all these down here, I'm gonna bet that they're all still good. Let's see what that is. I did find this right here was bent a little, which was making the string control drag up against this frame. So I bent that in a little to fix that to where it runs now without any drag. I could tell there was a little something weird about it. I'm going to clean these points. Where's the trouble at? Let's see. It must be up. I must have to do it right there. Yep. Good. And the Obviously, I want to be careful with the glass front on this. Also going to be careful about what kind of detergents I use. Because this, you know, the old screen printing on the back of this glass plate, I'm not sure how intact it is. I think what I'm going to do, and what I have been doing, is I've been putting this little foam brush down in behind here, and you have to be careful because obviously the strings that control the dials are here, and I've been brushing this off just gently, knocking the dust down, because there is many years worth of dust here. And then I turn the vacuum on and gently pull it out of there. Okay. Okay, I did find that looks like a leaky cap to me, and I believe there's one behind it that is a little leaky, so we're going to check the values on those, and we are going to replace those. Do you see these pots here? Watch when I pull this, when I rotate this. See that come out? Now go back in, come out, go back in. Look, same thing down here. See that? Those are those big tall pots on the back of that. I've never seen pots like that. But we're going to clean those. We're definitely going to replace that. I don't know about these other ones. It's going to depend. If I find something, that's the main output tube. That's that EL84. And these are, seem to be like preamp tubes. I'll bet you that right there is a rectifier. Wonder if this is solid state rectifier. Have I seen a date code on anything? So what we're doing now is trying to very gently get rid of 40 years worth of grit and grime, 40 or 50. I still hadn't found, I really hadn't looked hard, but still haven't found anything with the date code that I can decipher. Look at this. Just let you know what kind of buildup you get on stuff. And down behind here, see where those indicators are floating? Maybe if I put a little more light on there. Down where the indicators are floating, see that? There's dust, I'm sure, in behind here. Gonna have to carefully get down in there with something and clean the dust off the back of this indicator. And I'm sure it's not gonna be as bad as it is on the front, but it's just one of the things you have to do when you're working on this old stuff. I gotta find a detergent that's strong enough to remove this stuff, but you know, you want to make sure you don't pull any paint off of here, off the back of the dial face, because it's not painted on the front, it's painted on the layer that's in the back of the screen printing. And the old knobs and everything, I mean, look how crusty that knob is. So you can tell that's about where they kept that setting, sticking out of the front of the radio for years. You just have to go through and clean this stuff up. I generally do this while I'm waiting on my electronics to come in. And I did find three definitely leaky capacitors, and they're all this brand. And now when I say leaky, I mean I didn't check the values of them with to test their capacitance. I just saw, were they physically leaking? Are they leaking DC voltage? Most likely. When you see them bust open and leaking this stuff, they're also letting DC voltage bypass. So, or nothing bypass. So, I have ordered about 8 that I'm going to replace because they're all this brand. And I figure, and they're all high voltage. They're all anywhere from 125 to 500 volts. So, we're going to replace those and... And basically, I'm going to clean this thing up and put it back together. Because, like I said, it's very high quality. All the tubes are glowing that I could see. There's one in behind here that when I have the speakers hooked up, it's very difficult to see. I'll get a mirror to check that. Make sure that's glowing and looks good and not glowing too brightly. But this thing is just, it's put together with the best of components, and I would say that these are Eero brand, and I mean, even though there were a few of them that looked like they were getting pretty leaky, the thing still did work. So the idea is just replace those ones that look bad, and you know, this thing may have another 60 years in it. Hard to say. I also want to point out, as I'm cleaning around these buttons, I want to point out this clutch system. A pretty ingenious clutch system as to determining which indicator turns. This has AM, it has shortwave 1, shortwave 2, and it has FM. And depending on which one of these buttons is pushed, as to where the signal routes and what dial turns. You see these indicators moving for AM in both the shortwaves. Now, if I push the FM, those don't move. And you can see down along the bottom, you can see this indicator. Get some light on it. You can see this indicator moving down here along the bottom for the FN. That's the clutch system. Now, I am not taking these buttons off to clean this because after all these years, plastics tend to get brittle. And there's no need to take them off because all I do is push them down. I clean what I can clean with a nice gentle cleaner. In this case, I'm using just a little expensive, high quality glass cleaner. And just go along these and take those years of grime off. And you see it's coming pretty easily off the front of the keys. Well, I do the same thing in between them. It goes back to that old thing, if it's not broke, don't fix it. This is a very complicated clutch system that works to turn these tuners back here. And I don't want to take a chance on breaking one of these buttons because they're in really great shape. They're just dirty. So I'm just cleaning them the best I can. And hopefully, nothing cracks, nothing breaks, and the buttons are good and clean. So that's all I'm trying to do here. And this is off. This is phono. This is BC. This is broadcast. Now this radio doesn't transmit, but what it does, it has a input in the back. And y'all, I'm going to rig up, when I get it back together, I'm going to rig up an adapter that will allow me to plug a guitar into this. I believe you're going to be pretty amazed at what a little amplifier this thing's going to make. The speakers, I've already checked the continuity on all the speakers. All the speakers are working. They come out to about 5 ohms, and it recommends 7 ohm external speaker. So it's just, I got a feeling it's going to sound pretty great with the treble and the bass circuits on this, the preamp circuits. I got a feeling it's going to make an awesome sounding little guitar amplifier too. And it was made to put a microphone in, so you could use it as like a public address system, or you could plug the outputs of a tape recorder in and play tapes over this, and which would allow you to, since it's got that access already, you could actually hook this thing up to Bluetooth and broadcast your from your phone right to this thing. And you say, well, you know, how good does it sound? It sounds excellent. When I had music playing through it from a local radio station, man, it sounded awesome. The bass response in it is great, and the treble would go from like zero to extremely trebly. So pretty neat deal. Show you cleaning these serrations off. I just give a little bit of spray here. And take a brush and go down in those serrations and get all that good and clean. I don't spray this directly onto anything except where the overspray goes onto the table. That's fine. But like up here, I won't spray on this glass. I spray on the paper towel and then use it on the glass. So don't be spraying that junk. You know, this is basically water. So don't be spraying it in your electronics. Okay, I just wanted to show you that I couldn't, what I felt like, safely get down behind the glass, the screen printed glass plate, to clean this back. And as you can see, it had a ton of nastiness behind here. And so, against my better judgment, I gently loosened these screws and removed the screen printed glass plate. I got it set over in what I hope is a safe area. I cleaned the back and front of it very well. And now I'm going in and I'm getting all this mess out. Now, what a lot of people don't understand is when you work on things like this, this radio has parts that are irreplaceable. So if anything happens to the radio, I'm pretty much responsible for it. So, I mean, I bought it. You know what I'm saying? So that's one of the reasons why I am extremely careful when I'm working on this or a vintage amp. And like these capacitors, any part I remove and replace, I'll just put it in a plastic bag and give it back to the owner so they know exactly what I've done. But there's things like this that people don't take into account when you talk about working on an old. Obviously, this has nothing to do with the electronics, but I mean, I feel like I would be remiss in not cleaning this up as well as I can, you know, before the owner gets it back. Because, I mean, look at the back of these knobs where I couldn't reach with that glass plate on there. That needs to be cleaned up. So just be very careful when you're taking things off. Be gentle with how you have it sit. You know, you want to have it sitting so that this is up off the table, off these knobs, and that, you know, when you move around it, you don't bump into anything, you don't tear anything off. I just noticed that when I pulled these wires right here, this is a bi-amped system, which one of the reasons it sounds so awesome. It's got these speakers come out of this transformer, and these little tweeters on the side come off of this little transformer back here. And it's one of the reasons this thing sounds so awesome. These are seem to be 2-ohm speakers. Let me get over here where I can show you. These here seem to be 2-ohm speakers. This one is measuring about 6 ohms. So they're coming off different transformers. And pretty amazing stuff, man. It's just the speaker wires that go to this one, you see I have them marked so that I have the positive and the negative. And this right here, of course, these are 2 different color wires, so it's easy to keep those apart. But they go up in here. Pretty neat system. So as I'm cleaning down here, getting all this clean, I'm eventually going to have to move back to this end. I want to show you how this clutch system works. I will run all this down to this end. And leave it down there while I clean this in. So I want you to see how that clutch system worked. This is just it's a fun radio to work on. And it's generally what I would call out of my league. But you know, I'm learning as I'm doing. So the tube stuff and all that, you know, I'm used to that. But the tuners are pretty awesome in the way that they work. And just a lot of things I've never seen before because they don't apply to a guitar amplifier. So as I find those things, I'll point them out. It's like this little string here. You know, I can't imagine having to build one of these for scratch and route all these strings because they go under the bottom. They work the pots. Like when I do this one right here, you can see the rheostats pop up in these pots back here. You can see the little arms pop up. And so the strings run to this, all the way around here, to this, and then all the way across to this side where they're anchored in. It's just pretty amazing stuff. And obviously, you have to be very gentle with all this stuff, but it's really cool. I also wanted to point out while I'm cleaning this that I said, you know, if you break it with all these irreplaceable parts that you bought it, can you imagine if it was a family heirloom that somebody entrusted you with and you messed it up? What's the price on something like that? You know, wow. So keep in mind when you're cleaning all this, this has to be done extremely carefully. And take your time and pray that you don't mess up anything.
I don't know. Okay. She was weeping in the final look.
Tired of chasing rates? We get it. Rest assured, you're getting...
Racing with the wind, and the feeling that I'm under.
Run, run, reindeer.
I thought this thing would probably make a pretty good sounding guitar amp. Let's see. Don't mind my 60 cycle hum. That's the guitar. You know, this is single coil pickup. So. Let me see. Tell you what, since it's Christmas, I'll have a Christmas without you. I'll be so good just thinking about you.
Merry Christmas.